production of vitamins. Already we have seen in the second unit that most of the primary metabolites, either in organic acids or as alcohol or amino acids, we have seen some of the specific production in an industries. So here we are going to talk about vitamins. So we already studied what is vitamin, what is the importance of vitamins, and what are the types of vitamins in already in the 12th standard. So here we are going to see what is exactly the vitamin. It is nothing but an organic compound which will have varieties of vital roles in as well as growth, metabolism of a living organism. So it will be very specific in one of the activities because as I told you, like there are very different types of vitamins are available. So based upon that, the specificity of its function will also vary. Naturally, these vitamins are being present in the food sources. So once if we are taking all the vitamins, rich foods and all, it will reach us our body so that the growth as well as the metabolism will be increased. And this cannot be produced by any of the humans, whereas we can say like one of the microorganism can able to synthesis. So if the good bacteria is present in our gut, it can able to synthesize specific vitamins. So not a human can able to produce a vitamin, same like you can see the protein synthesis will happen in our body. So the same like the vitamins cannot be able to produced in a human body. So this is what the interaction. We have to know what is the types of vitamins. There are water soluble as well as fat soluble vitamins are available by nature. So water solubles are vitamin B as well as vitamin C, and fat solubles will come under vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E and vitamin K. So when we talk about here, we are going to see the production of one of the example is vitamin B12. Here in this diagram you can able to see types of vitamins starts from A, B, 1, B2, B5, B6, B9 and B12, C, D, E, K, some of the pro vitamins. These are the vitamins and also the food sources which will very rich for a specific vitamins we can see in this diagram. Then we will move on to the what are the types of vitamin B is present. So thiamine is nothing but a vitamin B1, riboflavin is B2 and pantothenic acid is B5 and pyridoxin is B6 and biotin is B7, folic acid is B9 and cyanogopalamine is nothing but B12. So here we are going to see about the production of B12. And the microorganism required for the commercial production of the vitamin, all these vitamins will be very specific. We know that if we are going for any commercial production, the microorganism, the raw material plays an important role. So we should be very specific over the production of that. Then what are the main activities or main functions of these vitamins? So when we see about the vitamin A, it is nothing but it is only for the healthy vision and also for creating some of the strong bones and teeth and all. It is naturally present in all of the items you can see here: carrot, egg, broccoli, then apple, and also in some of the papaya. So these are the common food sources. And when we see about the vitamin D, which can be able to absorb from the sunlight. So some of the people in the Western countries, they will go for the sun bath and all. So if they lack some of the vitamins, they will go for the sun bath. So it is very naturally present in the sunlight. So we can say like some of the food samples which can able to be there is cereals, milk, or some of the fishes we can able to get the vitamin D. And it will be plays an important role for absorbing the minerals, calciums and all from the food sources. So absorption plays an important role here in vitamin D. And vitamin E, next we are going to see about the vitamin E. Vitamin E will help to maintain the healthy RBCs as well as the muscles tissues. So it is commonly present in the peanuts and also peanut butter, avocado and also in almond. So these are the sources, food sources present in it. And then we will move on to the vitamin B. In vitamin B, the main we can see, like as I told you before, like vitamin B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B9, B12, and biotin, which is B7. All these will be present, and based upon that, we can able to classify the function. But still, the vitamin B will can able to help the body to turn the foods, all the foods, into an energy. It will also involved in the formation of RBCs and also the genetic materials, DNA and RNA synthesis. This vitamin B plays an important role. So it is present in some of the meat or else the bread sources and all, we can able to get it down. Then vitamin C. So C is commonly, we know that it is present in some of the citrus foods or else in tomato or some of the specific fruits and all, either strawberry, blueberry, all these things, raspberries, all these things, fruits will contain the vitamin C. It plays an important role for the collagen, and also it will, you know, that there will be an adhesion, cells will be present. So adherence of the cells will also plays an important role when it comes to vitamin C. It will also help to heal the wound. So if your immune system will be get boosted if you have a very good vitamin C present in it, and strong teeth and bones will be good. Then the last one is the vitamin K. So vitamin K is present in most of the green vegetables, we can say it. It is necessary for the blood clotting, and also these vitamins can able to synthesize in the intestine itself. So if the vitamin, if the bacteria is present, that is good bacteria is present in our gut, then it will specifically produce this vitamin K. So this is about the overall the types of vitamins and also some of the food sources, food rich, that is like vitamin rich sources. And then what are maybe the diseases will happen because of these vitamins? One is like the vitamin A is deficient, then some of the eye disorders or skin infections will occur. If the vitamin B9 has been deficient, then you can say some of the neural deficiency will happen here in the pregnancy time at all. And for vitamin B12, it is mainly for the anemic, and also the kidney liver disorders will be occur. If vitamin C is deficient, you can say some of the cancers or common cold or scurvy fever, all these things will be occur. And for vitamin D has been there, then it have been required for the tooth decay or else diabetes or arthritis or rickets will be happen. If the vitamin E is like, it can improve the blood circulation and also the aging processes. So if the vitamin K is given as a supplement, then the risk of the pain, internal bleeding can be reduced. This is the overall uses of vitamins. So if they found some of the deficiency and they found some of the diseases because of these vitamin, then they will take this vitamin as a supplement, which will be produced in the pharmaceutical industries in a commercial manner. That's why we are going to see here the production of vitamin B12. The overall vitamins uses, we can say, or an importance. So it is very essential for the growth, maintenance, as well as the reproduction. This is some of the, as I told you, like some of the fat soluble and water soluble vitamins are already available. The fat soluble vitamins will be useful for the color vision or blood clotting or bone formation or else for the membrane structure. So some of the water soluble vitamins will be plays an important role in the metabolism of carbohydrates, lipids, amino acids. So vitamin A and D will specifically act as in steroid hormones. So this is what the exact importance of both the fat soluble as well as the water soluble vitamin. Production of vitamin B12. So before going to the commercialization of this vitamin B12, we should know exactly what is vitamin B12. As we know that there are fat soluble and water soluble vitamins, so this vitamin B12 is commonly a water soluble vitamin, and it is generally called as cobalamin or cyanocobalamin. This vitamin have been earlyly discovered almost in 1920s. It have been discovered by two scientists. Minot and Murphy. So he have been underwent some of the experiments, and they have concluded some malignant anemia, which is called as pernicious anemia, have been cured by using this vitamin B12, because this will have a specific function over like the brain or the nervous system or the formation of red blood cells. All these things are the key role of this vitamin B12, and even though it will involves in some of the metabolic activities like fatty acid or amino acid metabolism, and it is very specific for the DNA synthesis. So this vitamin B12 will be commonly present in milk or milk powder or else in egg. So if we are going for any production process, we have to formulate the media. So in that, we can either use the milk powder or the beef extract along with the culture, so that the specific organism can grow very goodly, and the conversion of that vitamin will be very, very specific. So because of this advantages and also the involvement of this vitamin B12, most of the industries have been, pharmaceutical industries have been going for this production of vitamin B12, we can say it. Molecular structure of this cyanocobalamin. So it contains 63 carbon atoms, 90 hydrogen atoms, and 14 nitrogen atoms and 14 oxygen atoms, along with phosphate molecule and also cobalt. So it is the exact molecular formula of our cobalamin. So it have a specific uses, like it will act as a food preservative, a cofactor, or a protective medicine. So that's why we are going for the commercialization of this vitamin B12. Then we will see the production. So when we talk about the production, there are batch, continuous, fed batch processing. So by fermentation technology, but by the involvement of the microorganism, we are going for the production of this vitamin B12. Here we will see the batch as well as continuous gives a very good yield of our vitamin B12. And some of the antibiotics, initially when they have been underwent for the antibiotic production, during that time also some of the specific streptomyces species can able to produce this vitamin along with their main products, the antibiotics. So the yield is very, very low. So at that time only they have concluded that the fermentation technology plays an important role for the production of vitamin B12. So they underwent some of the research works, and finally they found out which organism will give you the very good yield of your particular vitamin B12. Then they have found out and they have used it down for the industries. So we can say like almost the 15 kgs of vitamin B12 have been produced annually. So worldwide, about all these vitamins have been produced, and it have been sent to the people who are deficient for this vitamin B12. And they have also underwent some of the research, and they found out that even in the sewage sludge, the vitamin B12 concentration is very, very high. This have been produced because of the microorganism present in that solid waste. So in United States, they have also recovered some of the vitamin B12 from the sewage sludges. And when we have know about there are chemical synthesis as well as a biological synthesis, when we talk about the chemical synthesis, they found that it is very, very complicated, because they have many different types of steps. Almost 20 steps have been involved in it. So that's why they found out some of the alternative methods, which is called as a fermentation method, and it is also named as a biosynthesis of that particular vitamin B12. So this is what exactly how the production is going to be happened. And the microorganism, whenever we underwent for upstream processing, we will have been framed about what is exactly the processing, which organism can able to give it, what are the raw materials required for that production. So if we are going to see some of the raw materials as well as the microorganism here. So the microorganism which can able to produce this vitamin B12, or we have been given in this table, you can see it, and also the mutant strain have been used for the production of this vitamin B12. So one is that propionibacterium bacterium species, and Rhodopseudomonas protalmicus, and propionibacterium bacterium shermani, Pseudomonas denitrificans, and Pseudomonas species. So all these have been directly used. The normal strain have been used. Some of the mutant strains of Rhodopseudomonas protalmicus have been used for the mutant strain, and it requires mostly the glucose, and some of the organism will require sucrose and also methanol. So this is the carbon sources, because carbon sources plays an important role for the conversion of our vitamin B12 by the micro.